Chances are when you go to a hospital, your primary care physician won't be following you. So how can your treatment plan stay coordinated?
And then the system will automatically route that call directly to the doctor's laptop using Lync technology. And then the doctor can actually see, oh, it's a nurse calling me about this patient.
We show you how care providers stay connected next on Health Tech Today. When a patient is admitted to the hospital, their care is transferred to a hospitalist, a physician who works exclusively at the hospital and understands the flow of treatment within that setting. Based in Columbus, Ohio, MedOne Hospital Physicians began offering hospitalist services in 2000. They've since developed the systems and software that help make clinical care more organized and efficient, resulting in better patient care. I'm pleased to welcome one of the founders of MedOne, Dr. Joseph Mack. Joe, great to have you on our program today.
Thank you.
So MedOne Physicians, you guys really understand the hospital environment. It's a complex place. Mm-hmm. It's busy. Workflows are crazy.
Right.
Clinicians are looking for solutions
yeah.
that work for them.
Right.
Tell me about the solution you came up with.
Well, taking all of the processes and systems going on in a hospital that can be inherently disorganized and getting it all organized, because anytime you get more organized and efficient, you can do a better job for your patient.
Organized is good. Uh-huh. Let's take a look at what you're doing.
Okay, sure. So let's go ahead and start with how the day starts. First thing is patient assignment. You have a list of physicians on the right here who are working today, and on the left side here, we still have some patients that need to be assigned. So that process will be carried out first thing in the morning. And then when each doctor shows up, the first thing that doctor will do is to define their rounding sequence. As soon as the system knows what sequence the doctor's going to round in, it mines a lot of data, looks at history trends and a lot of other variables, and then projects with remarkable accuracy what time that doctor's projected to get to each room.
And that's so important, not only for knowing that hopefully the patients can be in that room, but family members often are waiting around all day for when's the doctor going to show up?
Right. And it's been huge for family members, because when they know, okay, the doctor's going to be here between 10 and 10:30, that helps them out a lot.
You bet. What else?
MD Lifeline, that's what we call this part of our software, serves to bring all the information to the doctor that he or she needs to make the right, you know, clinical decisions for their patient.
So there's obviously some integration with the hospital information system.
Absolutely. Laboratory data, studies, transcription, medication feeds, all those come over, and then we present all that information to the hospitalist in a way that works best for the hospitalist.
In the way they want to work.
That's exactly right.
And also
right.
at the heart of this, I know, is Microsoft Lync. Tell me about what that offers.
Yes. Well, we took Microsoft Lync and we actually integrated it directly into our software. And so it ties into the physician schedule and everything else. So you can see who today's team is, and you can easily message your team and communicate. You can share desktops very easily. When a nurse needs to call in and get a hold of the doctor, they don't have to think about, okay, who's the doctor? What's their pager number? It's always the same phone number. And when they call the number, the nurse will state the patient's name, and then the system will automatically route that call directly to the doctor's laptop using Lync technology. And then it's really nice because we can answer the call from our laptops, so we remain hands-free.
So communication and collaboration in healthcare is extraordinarily important. Mm-hmm. What else can this do?
So everyone on the whole team has a global view of any new patients that need to be evaluated. And not only do we display this on the laptops, we also have a big billboard in our office that anyone in the office can also see that new patients need to be seen. And so here, in this case, we only have one new patient that needs to be seen that's coming in from the emergency room. But anyone from the team can see it, and then you can sit here and listen to why the patient is being brought in from the emergency room.
Wow, that's really terrific. Well, one of the questions I always like to ask, because after all, we're talking about healthcare, mm-hmm. people are cost conscious these days. How does this really drive value or savings, either to the clinicians or to the hospital itself,
right.
or to patient safety?
Right. You know, I mean, we see our customers as patients, hospitals, and doctors. And really what it comes down to, if you can do everything better, you can be more effective and more efficient in your work, you make winners out of everyone. So our doctors, we have more time for our patients, discuss their disease processes with them. At the same time, we're able to keep the hospital's length of stay down. We're able to help hospitals by keeping the length of stay down, not go on diversion. That's when patients have to go to a different hospital because you don't have room for them. And so by doing those kinds of things and a lot more, you're really able to bring value to all of these different customers. As one example, I can tell you, a 200 or so bed hospital that we started at 4 years ago, Their net profit in that first year, actually before our arrival, was $3.5 million. And by the fourth year, the net profit was $36.5 million.
Wow, that would convince anybody. That's pretty convincing. As you look ahead and you think about your software and where your company is going, mm-hmm. what do you anticipate for the future?
What we're really looking forward to is designing in Windows 8, you know, building Metro-style applications with touch screens, which I think it's just going to make everything that much more intuitive.
And intuitive is really important. Yeah. Well, Joe Mack, congratulations on the great work you're doing at MedOne. Thanks for using Microsoft Technology and Solutions. It's been a pleasure having you
Thank
on
you.
Health Tech
Thank
today.
You.
Thanks for joining us, and please come back soon for another episode of Health Tech Today. If you have questions or feedback on the show, please leave a comment on my health blog. I look forward to hearing from you.
For more thoughts, comments, news, and reflections on healthcare IT, join Dr. Bill Krause on Health Blog.